Good morning, everyone. So today we are starting at a new module, module number 5, conditioning of grinding wheel, which is also known as screwing and dressing. So this is the module that we are going to start today. So what is screwing, what is dressing, and why do you require them? If you recall, say for example, vitrified wheel. So vitrified wheel, you had the bonding material, you have the abrasive material, you had some dextrin, you mix them together, then for giving the shape, you put them in a mold and then you fire it. If it was a resin bonded wheel, procedure was similar. You put the resin, you put the plasticizer, you put the abrasive, get the mix, get the mold, and you, instead of firing them, you bake them. Just to remind you, this temperature was in this particular zone and this temperature was this particular zone. We are not much bothered about the temperature. What we are bothered about is this process. Ultimately, the shape of the grinding wheel is given by molding process. Here we have taken the most simple of all the shape, that is a disc type grinding wheel. So this is having an outer diameter and this is having a hole ID on which the spindle would be inserted and the grinding wheel would be mounted on the spindle. Now here in this particular diagram, I have exaggerated the eccentricity. I have exaggerated the eccentricity between the inner surface and the outer surface. And if this grinding wheel is mounted on the spindle and if it is rotated at 3000 RPM, enormous amount of unbalanced force will come and it will grind only on one side and the wheel will get broken because of the huge centrifugal force. So because of which this eccentricity has to be removed and the two surfaces are to be made concentric. How do you make it concentric? By removing the extra material. This material you have to remove to make it concentric so that the outer surface, new outer surface, becomes concentric with the rotary axis of the grinding wheel. Here everything is exaggerated. Typically this eccentricity would not be much. This eccentricity would be hundreds of microns. That means it would be less than a millimeter or a millimeter or so, not more than that. Molding process is also not that bad, but even that amount of eccentricity is not acceptable. Why is it not acceptable? Because our down feed or in feed in case of grinding is very less. In feed in case of cylindrical grinding is in this particular zone and down feed in surface grinding is in this particular zone. Because of that reason, this eccentricity has to be removed. This removal of eccentricity and making it concentric or making it true to run so that the wheel runs true, this process is called screwing. Both the spellings are used. I would be using this particular spelling, but depending on from which part of the world the book is coming out or the lecture is coming out, both the spellings should be used. Now, what is dressing? Dressing is after truing the wheel become glazed. What is glazing? If this is your grinding wheel and these are the grits, after dressing, what happens? Their tops or the cutting surfaces, they are removed, and this particular wheel almost look like a glazed wheel having no cutting ability. What do you mean by cutting ability? They would not be able to readily form chips during the grinding process. So, to summarize, truing is a process by which you remove the eccentricity and make the wheel concentric or true. Unfortunately, when you true a wheel becomes glazed. So, after that, the wheel doesn't have cutting ability. To impart cutting ability, to make the wheel open again, you need to do a process which is called dressing. Dressing has other purpose as well. We will come to that whenever we come to the next module. Dressing is done after glazing. For the time being, you try to understand. Dressing is done after truing. It is done after wheel wear. That means when the wheel or the grit, they have worn out, they are worn out, in that particular stage they are done. Dressing is also done after wheel loading, but you do not know at this stage what is wheel loading. So, if I may summarize once again, truing has to be done so that the eccentricity is removed and the wheel is made concentric with its rotary axis. Eccentricity seeps in because of the molding process. Unfortunately, truing makes the wheel glazed, and because of that, another process is required, which is called dressing. Dressing opens up the wheel. So, this is the basic definition of truing and dressing. What are they and why they are to be performed? Now, let us go to one of the dressing procedure. This is dressing of conventional wheels. Conventional wheels means alumina or silicon carbide wheels. Most possibly, they are vitrified bonded. These wheels are to be dressed or trued. For doing that, you require a cutting tool, which is called a dresser. This is a single point dresser, and this is a diamond dresser. This tip is the diamond. A single point diamond dresser is characterized by the weight of the diamond, like half a carat or 1 carat single point diamond dresser. So, this is your cutting tool. What do you do with that? This is your grinding wheel. This is your grinding wheel. This rotates with a speed of NS, and this particular dresser goes in this direction with a velocity VD, so that a lead of SD is obtained. How much is SD? SD, VD is nothing but pi DS sorry it is not that it is VD equal to SD into NS. So, from that SD can be obtained. So, this is the speed with which, so this is millimeter per minute and this is millimeter per revolution. there is an engagement between the dresser and the grinding wheel. That engagement is called depth of dressing or depth of truing, any one of them. The same dresser or same tool can be used like a dressing tool or a turn or a truing tool. The kinematics, as you can see, is very similar to turning operation. However, there is a slight difference. Difference is that cutting tool or the dresser is always inclined at an angle, and this angle is called drag angle. This drag angle is provided so that if the drag angle was in this direction, there is a possibility that it will eat into it. It may eat into the grinding wheel. So because of that, if your VS is in this particular direction, it is all drag angle is always given in the similar direction, so that there is no tendency of the dresser to go inside the grinding wheel and remove excess amount of material. Typical, what is the combination of SD AD? This is the combination of SD AD. However, I must mention, this is a general recommendation. SD, that is the lead of dressing, and AD, they are very much a function of DG, that is the grit size or grit diameter. So they are very much a function of grit size. If your grit size is around 100 to 200 micron, then these recommendations are fine. If your grit size is finer, then some other kind of recommendation would be there. Other than single point dressing, there is multi-point diamond dressing and there is clustered diamond dressing. I will show you what are they, then we will see. So in this particular one, what are the dressing parameters? How much is your SD? SD is related to VD. VD can be obtained as SD into NS. What is the other one? AD, depth is the other one. VS, with what speed the grinding wheel is rotating, that is one. Alpha D, drag angle, is another parameter, and typically truing and dressing is done under the application of coolant. So that is another parameter. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parameters which govern the dressing process. Other than that, size of the diamond is also important. And as you can see, the diamond is conical, and once again it poses a highly negative rake during the dressing process. What are the other kind of dressers we have? Before going into that, let us have a look at one dressing procedure. So this one shows dressing of a vitrified alumina wheel with a single point diamond dresser. So that what we have explained thus far. This is the forward pass. So there are two passes in a dressing cycle. Multiple forward and backward passes are given. This is the forward pass. So in this pass, as you can see, this was the grinding wheel which was rotating in this direction. This is the diamond dresser, and this moved from this side to this side. And now it will come back in the backward pass. So this is going to be the backward pass. So in that, so now in the backward pass, you can see, let me annotate you for you. So these are the grit materials and bond materials which are coming out of the grinding wheel. This is your grinding wheel which is rotating with NS, giving rise to VS. This is your diamond dresser. It is a single point dresser, and this being the backward pass is moving in this direction with VD, typically giving a lead of SD, and between the dresser and the wheel there is an engagement which is AD. So this is the way a single point dresser is used for dressing operation. I believe as because the size of the video is rather short, I will once again show it to you. This was the forward pass, and now it will come back with a fresh depth of dressing, and this is your backward pass. Typically in case of truing, after the final pass, several more passes would be provided without any fresh AD. So it is very similar to what we have learned about spark out phase. This is essential for getting good concentricity, but unfortunately these leads to glazing, and because of that, after truing you have to open up the wheel with dressing operation. During dressing operation, you choose your SD and AD in such a manner that you get proper open wheel. Now this is different kinds of dresser. This you have already seen. This is a single point diamond dresser. This can be also used for truing. This is a diamond cluster dresser, and this is called diamond dressing nib. So these can be used similarly. When you are using cluster or a nib, you have multi-point cutting, and in that particular case your SD would be larger. If we go back, we would be able to see that. If you see, your SD is larger in case of cluster diamond. AD more or less remains the same. Now another way it can be done, so this is your wheel. This is your wheel which is rotating in this particular direction with NS, and this is a conventional wheel. And it is a conventional wheel means it is a vitrified wheel, and this is a diamond dresser which is cylindrical in shape, so more like a diamond roll dresser, and it is more like a grinding wheel. This can be metal bonded or electroplated. This is positively driven. That means it can be driven in any direction. This is not frictionally driven. This can be driven in this direction or it can be driven in this direction. If it is driven in the positive direction, the surface speed, that is this VR and VS, they are within 80%. VR is typically 80% of VS, so that there is a slip velocity of 20%. If it is driven in the negative direction, in that particular case it is hardly 20%, so that there is a slip velocity, but this slip velocity is more than VS, and because of that you get dressing operation. Here also you have this in the dressing depth, and overall it can be plunge mode dressing. If the width of the rotary dresser is more, then it can be done in a single pass, or else you need to have a motion in this particular direction perpendicular to your screen, and the rotary dresser would be reciprocated in the perpendicular direction, so that the entire width of the wheel can be covered. Now let us see some of the videos that we have to show you standard dressing cycles. This one is a diamond cluster dressing, but it is a manual dressing. Let us have a look. So this is a manual dressing of alumina wheel with roller cluster dresser. This roller cluster dresser can be made of diamond impregnated in metal, or it can even be white cast iron, which are very, very hard. So this is the dresser, and this is your grinding wheel. This is your dresser, this is your grinding wheel, and this dresser is not positively driven, it is frictionally driven. So this is the dressing tool. It is having some these could be diamond impregnated metal bond. They are given a disc like feature, and this is your grinding wheel, which is being shown. Now let us start the grinding wheel, and it is pressed against the grinding wheel, and it is reciprocated, as you can see, to extend the entire width. This is a manual process. There is nothing automatic about it or powered about it. It is a manual dressing operation. Let us go to the next slide. This is a clustered diamond which is being used. Let us have a look at the video. We will explain it. This is a manual dressing of conventional wheel once again with clustered diamond dressing, and this clustered diamond has been held in place, or they are embedded in graphite carbide block, and that carbide block in turn is braced to the steel handle. So this is the carbide block in which diamond is embedded, and this is what the guy is holding, is the handle, which is steel, and they are braced together. And this process is going to be a manual process. So it is a manual dressing process that we are going to show you. So in this particular dresser, there is 4 carat worth of diamond, and it will last a very, very long time for normal dressing. So what he is doing is that there is a bench grinder that he is manually dressing, so that the bench grinder can be used for further operation. So he is gently pressing the dresser against the grinder and reciprocating it, so that the entire width of the wheel is covered. Thank you so much. In the next video, we'll go for super abrasive grinding wheels. So we will conclude 5.1A here. Thank you.